I was originally supposed to have Crystal DeSantos with me because I wouldn't have this gig if it wasn't for her. But she's busy. She's super busy. She doesn't actually live in Edmonton like the rest of us do, but she lives in Vancouver, and she's a very successful actress, and so she's busy filming something or with her own show, and I'm sure we will get together again and do something if she ever returns my calls. And then, of course, some of you knew Wency. She came with me to the preview show. She couldn't get the time off work. She's a working girl, and so couldn't get the time off work. And some of you may know of Louise Dawson, who's an amazing singer as well. And she says, yes, I'm totally on board. What day is it? Can't make it. So we don't have a ton of queens in this set. But all the songs that I picked for these women to sing, I decided to just change the key and sing them myself. Yeah, so this is Etta James. Woo!
Oh,
problems looking up and smiling at all of you. Right, Anna?
Yeah.
All right. I feel great. Folks, you are such a fun crowd to be sitting in front of. And again, good looking. Really good looking. I'm having a ton of fun. This is my first show of this kind of format. I've never really done a bunch of Elvis tunes and a bunch of oldies songs all in a row. And I've never really taken the time to get to know my crowd like I'm getting to know you today. So I really want to thank you for making this a really memorable moment for me. I love that. You're all enjoying it so far, are you? I'd like to draw your attention to a young lady who's over by the door over there. I was leaving with a strongbow in my hand, and she just happened to mention to me that she's security. And I told her I believed it because she looked really intimidating at the time, and she said, "My kids don't believe it." I didn't even catch her name. What's your name, man?
Janice.
Did you hear how she said that to you?
Janice.
Janice is going to kick my ass later. And I might just like it, Janice. Yes. James Brown, the Godfather, let's face it, he's the king of soul, right?
Yeah.
And what day, or what concert of royalty, music royalty, would be complete without Michael Jackson? This is not a cheesy gimmick, it's actually really cold outside. I know you guys are really excited. I can't find the other one right now, so...
Thank you.
All right. So from the King of Pop to the King of Blues, B.B. King. I think she likes B.B. King. She's from Mississippi. Couldn't contain herself, and that's what the blues is all about, folks. I teach singing every now and then, especially to children, and I tell them that there are five questions that you have to answer before singing any song. It's not just about the technique. It's not just about the notes that you hit. It's about how you hit them. And so I tell these five questions to all of my students. One is, who am I? In the context of the song, who are you? Second question is, who are you speaking to? Because every song is really just a conversation. The third question is, what do you want from that person? Fourth question is, what are you prepared to do to get what you want? And the last question, which most people overlook, is, what's going to happen to you if you don't get what you want? We took a real deep turn on this in the show, didn't we? All you were like, man. I'm going to go home and listen to my Adele songs right now and answer those questions. And so this is a perfect song for it because the song doesn't actually say a whole lot, but it's probably the definitive B.B. King song, The Thrill Is Gone. Let's go, baby. No, it was that bad. I'm so sorry. I'll try and make up for it. Okay, now.